have to find one first.
Lab coats on, goggles. The main idea of the camps. Gloves on. You guys are going to engage in research that's happening right now on campus. The activities.
The Summer Science Camp is an opportunity for high school students and teachers from rural Wisconsin communities.
More mature hot cells.
To come down to Madison and experience the academic excellence and cultural adventures of UW-Madison.
Which we are using for regenerative therapy.
And what it's like to be a college student on a large research campus.
This is a super useful, awesome instrument.
So I'm Dan Murphy, Outreach Coordinator for the Morgridge Institute for Research.
So you can press out all the way out and then try again?
The camp's main focus is and was based on regenerative biology and the stem cell research.
Very nice. Good job.
Mainly because at UW-Madison, at the Morgridge Institute for Research, it's such a huge focus of the research area, and historically and today.
You'll want to open up one of the flasks.
Researchers around regenerative biology have always been so excited to share their research.
Yeah, that's good.
And so this was a great opportunity to bring really great faculty.
All right, so we have our first measurement.
And their labs made of graduate students, undergraduates, and postdocs to come and do hands-on lab activities in the facilities we have here at the Discovery Building.
It has been amazing.
Press the tip on the side of the tube.
Students get some real hands-on experiences and cutting-edge research.
So I saw this as not only for them, but for me. You know, I knew great things were going on in Madison.
The one that you don't see up there is
to have them actually be able to speak to some of the people doing the work.
Okay, yeah.
3 out of 4, go.
You know, I knew it was gonna blow their minds.
We really like to take into account how cancer drugs actually affect people's bodies.
We had faculty who works in this building work with the students on breast cancer cells and culture.
So don't be afraid, you can sit in the chair.
And they were able to parallel an experiment that they do in their labs.
2 microliters, so you just twist the top.
Which is, how can we use cell culture and in some ways stem cells.
And now put it back in the microscope.
To make new and better drugs to improve human health.
We're learning a lot of things that I'm just like, whoa, I don't even know like anything about this stuff, but now I'm learning it.
Are we ready to start counting again?
So we had stem cell differentiated cardiomyocytes, which are beating human heart cells in the dish.
Here you can see the cell sort of beating and this.
The
right
students
here.
Got to see the heart cells beat in the dish for the first time.
Using the equation, we can calculate how much we need, how much volume of the drug we need.
And to test drug compounds on these heart cells in a way to see the response of the cells to the drugs.
We got to look at heart-like cells beating today on a computer screen, so that was really cool.
I think that we get such a great response from the researchers wanting to participate in the camp. Because they see the value in that these students are the next generation of stem cell scientists.
I'm really excited to learn about what's like to be a scientist. I'm really considering that field as a career.
You drop liquid into the larger circle.
The field that they see now is moving so fast that we need to engage students in science now in high school.
It's really important for students to know how the world works and how they fit into that world.
Yes, I'm going up.
Especially for these students that may not have had an experience around regenerative biology before, so that they can feel like they can do this kind of research.
I can do that. Using some reprogramming.
And there's also a value for the teachers to come to the camp too.
The heart and stem cells.
So they can take that back to their classrooms and engage their students.
All of the studies can be.
Because they're confident to talk about, this is what people are looking at right now. This is bringing life to my curriculum.
Now you're great.
Looking at all the stuff they're using, where do they get it? Just trying to think, how can I integrate these into my classes? How can I improve my curriculum for the next round of students that's going to come through?
I was in awe by it.
I'm going to try to get in.
I had always been interested in the idea of stem cell research. I just always thought it was fascinating. There were a lot of things that I learned, though, and things that I hadn't thought about. And I think my favorite part was talking about the ethics of it. No matter where they end up, I think that this is a really eye-opening experience for anyone from a rural community or any other high school to see research being done. It really opened up my mind to the opportunities that universities have.
So this is Will.
And I always tell the kids, you are the future. You are the future. You have to solve the problems of the world. I'm going to stay here and graduate high school students, and you are going to go on and do this.
This week has made me reevaluate my future, like what I want to do in college, being able to come here and like look at different kinds of research opportunities that I'll be having if I want to go to Madison or a different college with good sciences. This week has definitely made me change my perspective and like what I want to do. So that's really cool.